Hi guys, as you know, one of the most time-consuming stages in the data science project is data pre-processing. When it comes to data pre-processing, Pandas is an awesome Python library. Do you wanna add generative AI capabilities to this library? If yes, you should definitely meet Pandas AI. Pandas AI is a Python tool that powers the capabilities of Pandas by leveraging generative AI models. It not only allows you to easily deal with large datasets, but also helps you perform complex data manipulations. Today, we'll explore Pandas AI and cover how to perform data analysis with it. Here are the topics we'll handle in this video: installing Pandas AI, setting up Pandas AI, exploring data with Pandas AI, data visualization with Pandas AI. Let's dive in. Before getting started with Pandas AI, you need to install it. This is very easy to do using pip. All you have to do is use the command pip install Pandas AI. This is very easy, simple, right? You are ready to work with Pandas AI. After installing this tool, we need to import it. Let me write from Pandas AI import Pandas AI. Note that Pandas AI does not replace it. Rather, it's an AI tool that unleashes the power of Pandas. Now, let's import Pandas. Let's say import Pandas SPD. Note that Pandas AI works with large language models OpenAI. You can also use Hugging Face models and Google Palm for Pandas AI. In this video, we're gonna leverage OpenAI API. Let me import OpenAI from pandasai.llm.openai import OpenAI. Nice! We imported the necessary tools. Since we use OpenAI API, we need to set the OpenAI API key. To do this, we're gonna use the OS module. Let's import this module. Import OS. Now, all we have to do is set the OpenAI API key. Let's say OpenAI API key equals os.environ. Here, write your OpenAI API key. After that, we're gonna instantiate the OpenAI class with the API key. Let's do this. Let me write llm equals OpenAI. Let's write API token equals. Let's set OpenAI API key. Finally, we're gonna create a Pandas AI object using this llm. Let's say Pandas AI equals Pandas AI. Let's set LLM. Awesome! So far, we've imported necessary library and instantiate the Pandas AI object. Let's move on to how to perform data manipulation with Pandas AI. Now, we're gonna load a dataset and explore it using Pandas AI. The dataset we're gonna use is data science salaries. Let's load this dataset with Pandas. Let's say df equals pd.readcsv. Let's write ds salaries CSV. Next, let's take a look at the first 5 rows with the head method, df head. Here you go. This dataset shows salaries for different and contains 11 columns. Awesome! We've loaded the dataset. What we're gonna do to analyze the dataset is pass a dataset and a prompt to Pandas AI. Let's list the first 5 jobs title by salary. Response equals Pandas AI dot run. Let's set df prompt equals. Let's write list the first 5 jobs titles by salary in USD. Let's print response. As you can see, the first position with the highest salary is research scientist, followed by data analyst and AI scientist. Nice! We've seen how to select rows by speaking with the dataset. You can do this with Pandas, but it's easy to do with a prompt, right? Let's take a look at the average salary by job titles using Pandas AI. Let's say response equals Pandas AI dot run. Let's write df prompt equals. Let's set what is the average salary in USD by job titles. Make sure the output is sorted in descending order. Let's say response. Here, You can see the average salaries by job titles. Speaking to our data, it's easy to see average salaries, right? In data analysis, one of the easiest ways to understand data is data visualization. Let's examine top 10 job titles. To show this, let's say response pandas.ai.run, let's say df prompt equals, let's write plot a bar chart showing top 10 titles using different colors for each bar. Let's print response. As you can see for this chart, the most job title is data engineering followed by data scientist. Notice that it's not very difficult to plot a bar chart with a simple prompt. This is the power of the generative AI technology that is recently becoming more and more popular. Finally, let's handle how to plot a pie chart with Pandas AI. To show this, let's use the experience level column again and examine the distribution of this column. Let's say response Pandas AI. Let's call the run method. Let's write df prompt equals, let's say plot a pie chart showing the experience level distribution. Let's print response. As you can see, the senior level positions have the highest count, followed by mid-level and junior positions. There are fewer director level positions compared to other levels. LLMs are a game changer in AI. Pandas AI is a great tool to gain insight from datasets by leveraging the power of LLMs. Trust me, this AI tools is a new revolution in data analysis. It helps you easily handle your complex tasks in data exploration and data manipulation by talking to your data. This library also enables you to overcome challenges in big data with generative AI capabilities. Note that it still has limitations and cannot fully replace humans, like all AI tools. So, the accuracy of the analyzed result needs to be checked by humans. In this video, we covered how to install, set up, and work with Pandas AI. We also saw how to plot charts to explore data. You can find the link to this notebook in the description. That's it. Hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and like the video. See you in the next video. Bye for now.